So video advertising formats within display, there's three really common formats, varieties. First of those being the traditional sort of pre-roll, mid-roll advertising, which is very similar to the TV, which you'd all know from on-demand players and YouTube. It's basically video advertising that sits around video on-demand content. There's video advertising in expandable display banners. So if somebody interacts with that unit, the ad will expand over the screen and you get a space to play a video and put other information besides. And lastly, there's video creative that will sit with inside a standard size display advertising unit, whether that's an MPU or a leaderboard or a Sky. And that's the three most common formats that we use for display.
So with the range of different assets and different types of display, it's really important that your assets are fit for purpose. That's not just in terms of file size and aspect ratio, but also structurally in terms of the story and narrative.
If we continue with our three examples of creative formats, let's look at the top of the funnel. Traditionally, you'd use pre-roll and mid-roll as a true awareness piece. It's very akin to TV advertising. And the messaging, Abby, I think, and everything is quite similar.
Yeah, so they're very story-led. The message is often revealed later on. It's more of a soft sell approach than some of the other types of advertising. Because they're 16:9 aspect ratio, companies do often repurpose existing TV assets. So they're quite an easy one for companies to be able to do. The aim isn't direct conversion. Generally, conversion happens in a more seemingly organic way where someone searched later on and all the video's done sown a seed earlier on in their journey.
So things that still have a foot in awareness, but are now going down the funnel, so a little bit more direct response led, where we're trying to actually sell some units, create some registrations, make a user more engaged with that brand through the advertising formats. And this is where the expandables start to come in. And the reason for that is there's a price differential, and also you can change the messaging and you can get you can reach people in more environments with a display ad creative that expands than you can with a video pre-roll. So that's why we start to use those at that stage in the journey.
Yeah, so because they vary in terms of shape, size, they have to be bespoke made. You can't just chuck something in that you've already used for TV or for another type of display. Structurally, they hit really hard with a call to action quite early on because they're super short and you've not got the time to be able to deliver a real story. And the aim is direct conversion and click-through.
If we think that was expandable creatives, if we talk about actually putting video within the banner size itself, we have more restrictions in terms of how we can do it. But we can be more ubiquitous with putting those adverts over the web, and we can reach more people, and we can do it even more cost-effectively than we can with the expandables. So you can see there's a price thing going on as we go down the funnel. As we get to the bottom, we need it to be more accountable, therefore better value. But also there's, again, a creative message that changed and some production values, I think, that need to be considered. So we've looked at things from an acquisition point of view. There's also a retention and advocacy element to this as well. And videos serve a wonderful purpose for this. And site-based stuff is a great way to entertain, keep your customers.
So when you land on a site, whether it's through search or through clicking on paid advertising, obviously you're a warm audience. So you've got there because of an interest. You're there because you want to be there. So videos tend to be friendlier. The aim is to really engage with the brand. So they could be how-tos, testimonials. They're generally more people-led. And also sort of longer versions of the initial advertising, so it really sort of ties back in and creates that kind of brand halo effect.
It really works with the tone of voice of your brand as well, and they can be anything, and that's where you start to match, and that's where the production values really add to that.
Yeah.
So with multi-channel stuff, just in digital, it's more important than ever to keep some continuity against your messaging. And we've talked about using video for different purposes, and I think that continuity needs to flow through, doesn't it?
So all too often we're seeing people repurposing assets, and rarely does stretching or cropping photos or video work well. We should be briefing them in at the beginning stages of planning for a shoot. So if you've already got a shoot planned, then get thinking about how you're going to use those assets and what you could possibly use them for, because it doesn't take long to add in a few extra shots that really could make the difference to your advertising campaign.
Absolutely.